Hi everyone. Now we are going to discuss about Bulgarian milk, which is one of the types of fermented milk or microbial product of milk. Let's see how can we define a Bulgarian milk. As I told you, Bulgarian milk refers to a fermented milk product obtained with Bulgarian symbiotic starter culture. Bulgarian symbiotic starter culture, that is nothing but a combination of Lactobacillus bulgaricus and Streptococcus thermophilus by an original technology without any additives. So here we are not going to have any additives, that's why this is going to be coming from the original technology. Then coming to the process and fermentation of Bulgarian milk. So this process and fermentation in general, I told you in the previous video, that is fermented milk, where each step was explained in detail. Now here we are going to go through all the steps. You can have the reference from that video also to understand more. So here, first of all, we are supposed to have the selection of the milk, and that selection of the milk here is the skimmer milk that may be from the goat or the cow's milk. Once we have selected and we had gone through all the selection, then the heat treatment have to be done. That heat treatment is nothing but the pasteurization, and that is going to be done at 80 to 85 degrees centigrade for 30 minutes. Once the pasteurization is completed, that milk have to be cooled down to a temperature of about 18 to 20 degrees. For instance, if it is a small quantity, we can take a large pan with a cold water and we can keep our hot milk vessel in it to make it to cool. So once it has come to 18 to 20 degrees centigrade, we are supposed to add the inoculation. That means we have to add the inoculum. The process is called as inoculation. So what is the inoculum here, or the starter culture? The Lactobacillus bulgaricus and Streptococcus thermophilus is going to add as a starter culture. If we are not going to have the starter culture, we are supposed to add the 10 to 30 ml of sour milk or buttermilk in a liter of milk. So 1 liter of milk, we are supposed to add 10 to 30 ml of the sour milk or the buttermilk. Then we have to leave it for about 18 to 24 hours at a room temperature of around 38 degrees centigrade, and that process is going to be called as incubation. If the surrounding temperature is going to be of more than this, that means above the room temperature, so obviously that fermentation is occurring very fast. That means our fermentation time will be reduced. So after this, our formation of the coagulum, that means our buttermilk, that is Bulgarian milk, is ready. And we are supposed to have the churning, that means to make it, it will be in the form of a solid like our curd, and that have to be churned so such that it forms into a milk. So once the milk is ready, store it in a cold place, that means cool basement or a refrigerator. If you want to keep it for some more days, you are supposed to have the storage at 5 degrees centigrade or by the packing process, and that also have to be kept in the cool places. So this is all about the total process and fermentation of the Bulgarian milk. So let's move to the steps that whatever I explained is in this form of the sentences, you can go through it. Now moving to the health benefits of Bulgarian milk, which is very important. So as we know, Bulgarian is one of the countries with the biggest amount of people who aged above 100 degrees and older. The reason behind that is consumption of this Bulgarian milk. And this Bulgarian milk or yogurt is one of the best probiotics out there, where probiotic means for life or refers to living organism that can result in a health benefit when eaten in adequate amounts. We have discussed the probiotics topics in detail in another video. You can go through it. Then what are the different basic health benefits that we are getting? Means the first one is a boosting immune system, where the Bulgarian milk supplies the colon with beneficial bacteria like Lactobacillus bulgaris, which is one of the beneficial microorganisms that have positive effects on the colon microflora. And now what it is doing, these bacteria are going to boost the immunity as well as heal the gut. Now, the health balance between the good and bad gut bacteria is the key to maintain a strong immunity. So that's how the Bulgarian milk is involved in the boosting the immune system. Then coming to the second point is lactose intolerant friendly. So the Bulgarian milk is very low on lactose because of the transformation causing from lactose sugar to lactic acid. And as this transformation occurs, there will be no problem with the lactose digestion. So if this Bulgarian milk, suppose if it is prepared from the goat milk, and the goat milk is going to have the low quantity of the lactose, which is perfectly healthy meal for people with lactose intolerance and respiratory problems or issues. Then the third one is, the Bulgarian milk may heal gastrointestinal issues including the severe diarrhea. So as I told you that Bulgarian milk is acting as a probiotic, this is going to be an excellent diet food, and the active cultures like Lactobacillus bulgaricus is going to help certain gastrointestinal conditions including lactose intolerance that I told you now, then constipation, diarrhea, colon cancer, inflammatory bowel diseases, and some of the diseases or the ulcers that are going to be caused by what we call it as Helicobacter pylori infection and many others. So that's how it is very involved in healing the gastrointestinal issues including the diarrhea. Then coming to the fourth point, that is excellent for weight loss. That means those who want to reduce their weight because of overweight, so this Bulgarian milk is going to be as a source of excellent for weight loss. How? The Bulgarian milk contains lots of easily digestible proteins and low amounts of carbohydrates, which is suitable for a ketogenic slimming diet plan. So that's how it makes an excellent for achieving a healthy and slender shape. As this Bulgarian milk nutritionally sound, and it also makes you feel fuller faster, and it is also a good source for proteins too. Okay, then it is going to promote the anti-aging and longevity. The Bulgarian milk is going to promote the anti-aging and longevity. According to the founder of immunology, who is the founder of immunology? Metchnikoff. The probiotics, that is Lactobacillus bulgaris bacteria, in the Bulgarian milk tend to inhibit the growth of colon bacteria that stimulate auto-intoxication that is occurring in our colon. So as a result, so if this auto-intoxication is going to be stopped, as a result, people consuming large amounts of traditional foods like yogurt, kefir, this Bulgarian milk, all have a longer and healthier lives. There are different stories based on this also. You can go through it. Then coming to the last point, it prevents the osteoporosis also. That means the Bulgarian milk is a perfect prevention for osteoporosis because it is supplied with plenty of vitamins like A, B, C, D, and E. I'm not reading the alphabet. Those are all the types of vitamins present in it. And some of the minerals like potassium, calcium rich, then sodium, iodine, iron, cobalt, zinc, nickel, etc. These essential compounds make this Bulgarian milk excellent for nourishing the body and as well as the bodybuilding, its immunity, and preventing various diseases like osteoporosis and even cancer too. Okay, so these are the few health benefits of the Bulgarian milk consumption. I hope so you understood very well. We will discuss the kefir in the coming video. Thank you.